Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Oscar Buzz Trevor here, and I'm joined by Thomas and Jack returning to the channel.
Hello.
So the HCA just did their mid-season awards, and we did a little bit of a reaction, and we talked about them a little bit. And in the end, do they mean that much? No, not really. They're just for fun. So we figured, why not do our own? So this is going to be our quote-unquote mid-season awards. It's just going to be our favorite stuff that we've seen so far this year, basically. So be doing screenplay, four acting categories, best director and best picture. Be five nominees in each category except for best picture, which will have 10. We're just going to say our individual lists, then kind of come to an agreement if we can on the nominees and the winner. Also, Sam, who is another regular guest on the channel, he's texted me a couple of his choices, and what he would be very passionate about pushing in each category. So I will be relaying Sam's, but he cannot be here today because he died. So let's get started with best screenplay, and let's have Jack go for it.
Okay, I only did four here because I'm limiting myself to not including stuff that I'm not super fond of because I haven't seen a ton of things. So I did Rye Lane, Beau Is Afraid, Blackberry, and Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse for my score.
Okay, interesting. I've got two crossovers. My fifth is Spider-Man. I think it's worthy. I mean, people have talked about potentially getting into the Oscars, which is great. And for Rye Lane, delightful screenplay, delightful film. Then number three, You Hurt My Feelings. I mean, it's about a writer. It is very sort of snappy in its dialogues, just a sort of screenplay I like. And then Joyland, which, it's
Nice.
debatable whether it's 2022, 2023. I chose to include it as 2023. Same with Mars One, which is my winner in this category. Just a great screenplay all around. I think it's really the screenplay in combination with performances that make that film so good. And again, it's another one that potentially 2022, I don't know, it's arguable. I decided to include them here because they really strengthened the lineup, I won't lie.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. My pick, so I also have Rye Lane, so we can definitely be nominating that since it's we all have it. That's my number five. My number four is Showing Up, new Kelly Reichardt. It's brilliant. Number three, I have Waiting for the Light to Change, really good indie from Lynn Tron. Number two is where I've put Asteroid City.
Okay.
Just really loved it. And then my number one is Past Lives. Of course, I'm the only one that is here on this
I haven't
panel that
seen
has
it.
seen it.
Yeah, I haven't seen
Sam also, he just said screenplay, Past Lives. Just
it. Right. Yeah.
very, very
Yeah.
strongly pushing for
Yeah.
that. So, I think we can have Past
I
Lives
haven't seen it, but
in.
if I had
Yeah.
seen it, I'm sure I would agree.
So I think Past Lives in, Rye
Rye
Lane
Lane
in,
in. Yeah.
Spider-Verse in, because we both had Spider-Verse.
Yeah.
Yeah, Spider-Verse would be close for me. I'm perfectly fine having that in. I would strongly push for Asteroid City.
I haven't seen it, so.
Yeah.
Depends on if you're up to
I would happily
on
put
this.
it in. It would be around my lineup.
Okay.
So I would happily put it in. Yeah.
So we have Fast Lives, we have Rye Lane, we have Spider-Verse, we have Asteroid City. Anybody else passionate about anything? I'm fine with Waiting for the Light to Change and Showing Up missing. Thomas, your number one is
Yeah.
Mars One.
I would like either Mars One or Joyland. I don't know. It can be either of them. They're very close in my book. So, because I know
I
you
would
prefer
prefer
Joyland, so
Joyland.
I'm
And Jack,
perfectly
what
happy.
was your number one, Jack?
My number one, if I had to put number one, was probably Rye Lane. So
Okay.
I'm good with
Okay, so
that.
we
There's
have that
nothing else
in.
that I'm super passionate about
So
in the
if you want to
screenplay.
do Joyland then, because
I'm
you've
fine
heard
with
that one,
Joyland.
perfect. Cool.
So our lineup is Past Lives, Rye Lane, Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse, Asteroid City, and Joyland. If we have to pick a winner, I know Sam and I would be pushing for Past Lives.
I would
And
say
if I'd seen
Joyland.
it, I probably would
Yeah.
too,
I mean,
but
yeah, that is a thing. That is a thing.
I can't.
I mean, I know that it would obviously be up there, so I'm happy if we want to just go for Past
Yeah.
Lives. I think the more
Okay.
diplomatic choice would potentially be Rye Lane, but yeah,
Be the
I'd say it's up
runner-up.
to you. Yeah. Yeah,
We'll
Rye
give
Lane could be
Rye
the winner.
Lane. We'll give Rye Lane runner-up, and we'll say Past Lives is the winner. All right, best supporting actress. So how are we feeling here? I'll start with Thomas.
Well, I thought this one was notably easier than supporting actor. I will say that. I think there has been more, which weirdly the sort of reverse was the case in lead. But supporting actresses, I've got Viola Davis in Air. I thought she was probably undoubtedly
Okay.
almost the best performance in that film. You will see a couple of other performances because I was scratching for options. But Viola Davis, Rachel McAdams, Are You There, God? It's Me, Margaret. Great performance from her. And then Camilla DeMille, I'm going to go with that pronunciation, from Mars One, the daughter in Mars
Okay.
One. I thought she was pretty excellent. And then the top two, both from Joyland, Rusty Farocq, I'm just going to go with that as a name. And then Alina Khan, I thought, was the standout supporting actress performance in the first half of the year for me. She is absolutely incredible in that film.
Yeah, completely agreed. Jack, what do you got?
I didn't rank mine, but I have Rachel McAdams for Are You There? God, It's Me, Margaret. I did put in Viola Davis for Air, just she's good in it.
Yeah. It's my number five.
Like, yeah. It's like an open spot, I guess. Like, she was the best part of the film, but I don't think it's like an incredible per se.
Yeah.
From a film that hasn't released yet, but I did see it at Sundance, I put Marsha Debonis for Sometimes I Think About Dying. She has like two scenes in that, and she was a standout for me. Then it got a little tricky. Then I think, Patti LuPone for Beau Is Afraid.
Nice.
And I think that's really it. I don't think I have a fifth spot.
Yeah, that's fair. I found this category. Yeah, there were a couple in Joyland and Mars one.
If I counted Joyland, I count it technically as 2022, but I'm fine with having it over here in 2023.
Nice. Cool. So my top five. So my number five was Adela Exarchopoulos for Passages. She's brilliant in it. Just great performances all around in that film. You'll see it more. Hong Chau in Showing Up, I thought was great. Scarlett Johansson in Asteroid City. I thought that she was alongside Schwartzman, the standout performance in it. And then I also have Patti LuPone in Beau Is Afraid. And then I have Alina Khan in Joyland. And then Sam had Alina Khan and Hong Chau as his top option. But okay. I completely agree. I think Alina Khan is like far and away like the best of the year. She's my number one. So we can have Alina Khan in, I think. It's
safe. Yes. And I guess the other crossovers are Hong Chau, Rachel McAdams,
Viola, you guys both had.
Yeah, but that's that
you can
Heidi LuPone, both Jack and Dad.
Yeah.
So our five nominees are Alina Khan for Joyland, Hong Chau for Showing Up, Rachel McAdams for Are You There, God It's Me, Margaret, Patti LuPone for Beau Is Afraid, and Viola Davis for Air. For winner, I would strongly push for Alina Khan.
I think that is a consensus winner.
Cool. And for runner up, how are we feeling?
I'm not that fussed, I won't lie. Between Rachel McAdams is a bear. That's my only other horse in the race, I think, technically. So
I thought Patti LuPone was great.
I'd be fine with Patti LuPone.
I'd be fine with that. I did at least see Beau Is Afraid, whether I haven't seen Showing Up yet. But yeah, cool. So I'd be fine with that being a runner.
Let's go Patti LuPone. All right, best supporting actor. I'll lead off with this one. My number five is Jason Momoa for Fast X. Yes, I have seen 75 films that are new releases this year, and Jason Momoa still makes the list. I thought that he was amazing. That is the gay representation that we need. Then I have Noah Galvin for Theater Camp. Thought was great. Thought he completely stole the show. Has an amazing final sequence in it. Just incredible. Ben Whishaw for Passages. This line is just very full of gay characters. Ben Whishaw, great Passages. Again, just like the tension that's operating between all three characters in that it's ridiculous. And then my top two are Yuteo and John Magaro, both for Past Lives. Yuteo, I think, is supporting. I mean, it's very debatable, but I've put him in supporting just because I think that supporting actor is a far weaker category than lead actor. So I've thrown him in here. Sam's only two that he threw in here were John Magaro and Yuteo.
Okay. So. Fair enough. I guess I'll go next. I deliberately chose to stay away from Jason Momoa. He was actually close, which is worrying, as was like Dave Bautista from Knock at the Cabin. That's how weak this category really was, in my opinion. So much so that we are getting Jason Bateman for Air. I thought he was the best male. I thought he was better than Ben Affleck or Chris Messina. I thought, there's a fifth spot here. Let's just honor one of the supporting actors from Air. There was nothing else. I'm not doing Jason Momoa. I'm sorry. I'm not going there. Then we have Arian Moed from You Hurt My Feelings.
Sick. Succession rap.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Exactly. Great in that. Glenn Howerton, Blackberry, which it is debatable whether he is supporting or lead, but the HGAs that him supporting, so as will I. Then Carlos Francisco, who is the dad in Mars One. Again, arguably he is probably the lead, if anyone is the lead in that film, but it is such an ensemble, like you are following all four of the family members. Yeah. I thought they're all supporting. And then my winner, which surprised me, but he really did surprise me how good I found him in this film. Tobias Menzies for You Hurt My Feelings, the husband character. So, nice. Yeah, like he really surprised me how just good and how his comedic timing and all of that kind of stuff. So yeah,
Sam did actually, Sam listed him as well. He put him in lead, but I think that he's supporting. So we'll throw him in supporting here.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. No, he's very good in the film. He's very good.
Yeah.
Well, just like you refuse to do Jason Momoa, I refuse to do any air actors in here.
Yes.
I don't think that I could put them. That's once again, I don't have five people in here, but I could have put them in, but I'm not going to. I guess I would put Glenn Howerton first, but in no particular order. Glenn Howerton for Blackberry. I did Nathan Lane for Beau Is Afraid. I thought he was very good in that.
Okay.
I did do Jason Momoa for Fast X.
Oh, yes.
He saved that entire film.
He's going to get in, isn't he? He's going to get in.
Yes, he is. Yes, he is.
Yep. And then instead of anyone from Air, I did think Dave Bautista was pretty good in Knock at the Cap. Probably the only good part about that movie, I think.
Okay.
Yeah.
So here's what we're looking at. I mean, I would love to throw Ben Wish on there, but nobody else has seen the movie. I mean, technically, it doesn't even count as midseason. It's coming out in August, so I'm fine with leaving that off. But
yeah.
Just want to throw that out there. So John Magaro and UKO, both in, I would say for sure, because Sam and I both have them as our top two. Tobias Menzies, I think, is in, since Thomas is your winner.
Yeah.
And has him in.
Jason Momoa is in.
Jason Momoa and Glenn Howerton are the only other two with crossover.
Yeah. And there we go. I'm happy with that.
So our nominees are John Magaro for Past Lives, UKO for Past Lives, Tobias Menzies for You Hurt My Feelings, Jason Momoa for Fast X, and Glenn Howerton for Blackberry.
Right.
And I would like John Magaro.
Yeah. Okay.
Probably.
I think it is fine to do one of the Past Lives if then we can maybe do like Tobias Menzies as a runner up rather than just doing both Past Lives, winner and runner up. I think that's probably the fairest way of doing it.
Yeah.
Yeah. If you want to give it to John Magaro, fine.
Yeah. Because, like, I don't know what Sam's preference would be between John Magaro or UTO. He did tell me. But I also think John Magaro is also brilliant in Showing Up. So I think it's fair to just kind of throw him collective award for the beginning of the year. So if we're going to say John Magaro. And then I like having Tobias Menzies as our runner-up. I think that worked. And we can throw Glenn Howerton an honorary third place. That won't be reflected. So,
yeah.
Yes. Though we all know that Jason Momoa should be winning this, but it's okay.
Can't believe you got into the HCA and our HCA noms as well.
He was pretty good.
He's like that is what that's what these movies should be like.
Yeah, I don't know. Perfect. I don't know. His character was incredibly underwritten and nothing. So
that's not his fault.
Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter.
Anyway, he made the writing better with his performance.
He genuinely made, He did with that what Ana de Armas couldn't do for Blonde. And Ana de Armas got an Oscar nomination, okay?
Are you can't be campaigning Jason Momoa for an Oscar nomination of Fast X. Vin Diesel
I would not be opposed.
He's wanted to get in.
It
and
would
the
be
one person hates.
It would be objectively the funniest thing the Oscars have ever done, and I am all here for it.
Yeah, like, it would be funny.
Tell me that you wouldn't want to wake up on nomination morning and hear them say Jason Momoa for Fast X. Like, you can't convince me that you wouldn't enjoy that.
It would be
like that would be really that.
It would forever taint the Academy Awards. Anyway,
they've already ruined their
reference. Yeah.
Okay, let's talk about Best Actor here. So Jack, we'll go back to you.
Okay. I have David Johnson for Rye Lane. I thought he was great in that movie.
Yep.
Joaquin Phoenix for Beau Is Afraid, who would probably be my number one if I ranked them. Then I have Jay Baruchel for Blackberry.
Okay.
And then it gets hard for me. I think I'm not going to include one particular Sundance film, even though I thought it was a good performance.
Oh,
so
I with a particular initials of JM.
Yeah. Possibly. So instead, I will, I'll say Michael B. Jordan for Creed. I don't know.
Okay.
I mean, he probably won't get in.
But
yeah, he was genuinely close to mine. But I did replace him with my number five. You can probably guess what it is at this point, because in both supporting actor and supporting actress, my number five would have been from the same film, which continues here. Matt Damon. Matt Damon does give a good performance in Air. I genuinely think he is like a pretty solid performance in Air and worthy of this nom. But he is number five still. There is enough people. There is enough people over him.
Really?
So let me see if I can fix my reputation with these other ones. So Jason Schwartzman, Asteroid City. Schwartzman was good. Joaquin Phoenix, Beau Is Afraid. I didn't really like Beau Is Afraid. His performance, undeniably very impressive. David Johnson for Rye Lane. I thought he was excellent along with his co-lead, which we'll get to that. And then Ali Jinzhou for Joyland, giving them both a win. I gave Alina Card a win. I gave giving him the win as well. I thought they were excellent together. They had a real chemistry together, which means I think they both.
I mean, Joyland's is so brilliant. Like, what a film. What a film.
Yeah.
Okay. So Sam had David Johnson and then Joaquin Phoenix.
Okay.
And I also have them as well. So my number five, Jason Schwartzman for Astrid City. My four is Christopher Abbott for Sanctuary. God, he's so good. We're all succession heads here. That is literally just like it could be about Roman Roy, that film.
Oh, really? Okay. Like, okay.
It's very Roman core. And it's great. Like it's like a wild, horny episode of Succession. It's amazing.
Right.
My number three is David Johnson for Rye Lane. My two is Franz Rogowski for Passages, but again, debatable whether we're gonna count Passages. Like that's why like I just saw Joyride. Brilliant. It's technically a July film, so like doesn't count. I don't know. And then my number one is Joaquin Phoenix for Beau Is Afraid. So I think very obviously Joaquin Phoenix and David Johnson are in. They're I think everybody like we all have them in as all within our top.
Yeah, like David Johnson, my number two. Yeah. And Joaquin's number three, so yeah.
Cool. Other crossover, Thomas, you and I both had Jason Schwartzman.
Is that the only other crossover?
No one else. Yeah. Shockingly.
Kiss me on that one.
No, thank you.
So we can put in your number one since you don't have your number one. He's great in Joyland. So, Ali.
Very happy with that.
Junejo?
Junejo.
So sorry. Junejo. We're going to go with Junejo. I can't speak, apparently. Ali Junejo. And then for the last slot, so Jack, you have Jay Burscheller, MBJ. I have Franz Rogowski and Christopher Abbott. Thomas, you have Matt Damon.
I've only got Matt Damon left to complete my five. I think we can do it.
We aren't doing Matt Damon.
No.
So I guess it's Christopher Abbott, Jay Burscheller, MBJ.
I'm not passionate about either of those. So if you're passionate about Christopher Abbott.
I would like Christopher Abbott in.
Yeah.
That's perfect fun. Yeah.
Possible?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Yeah. So our lineup is Joaquin Phoenix for Beau Is Afraid, David Johnson for Rye Lane, Jason Schwartzman for Asteroid City, Ali Junejo for Joyland, and Christopher Abbott for Sanctuary. As far as our winners, so Sam had Joaquin and David Johnson. Yeah. My number one is Joaquin.
He'd be mine,
Jack
too.
Said that was his as well. So yeah, I'd say go Joaquin winning, David Johnson runner-up.
David Johnson runner-up. Yeah. Well, Joaquin Phoenix has won the Oscar Buzz Midseason
Better
Award.
Better performance than his Oscar-winning one.
Agreed.
Disagreed, but again, I'm gonna be alone on that one.
We didn't ask for your opinion, Thomas.
Sorry, I'm just gonna, you know, I've got to be the voice of the people in this call.
Got to be the voice of the film bros.
Exactly, whilst not being one myself.
You're uncomfortably close. Okay. Best actress. So of course, Sam, as a gay man, this was the only acting category that he gave me a full list for. And ranked too. Only one he put effort into. Okay. So let's start with Sam's list. He went in order: Greta Lee, Past Lives; Jennifer Lawrence and No Hard Feelings; Michelle Williams for Showing Up; Julia Louis-Dreyfus for You Hurt My Feelings; and Vivian Aparo for Rye Lane.
Yeah, I'm assuming that's going down. Okay. So Greta Lee.
Yes.
Just
establishing.
Cool.
Jack, you go.
Okay, so I've got Vivian Aparo. This is not once again ranked. I've got her. I've got Tiana Taylor for 1001. I thought she was incredible in that. Then I've got, where did it go? Daisy Ridley, once again, for Sometimes I Think About Dying.
Nice.
Then I didn't think about that, but I think Jennifer Lawrence for No Hard Feelings would probably be worthy, honestly. And then Storm Reid, I thought, even though it's not an incredible movie, I thought she was very good in Missing.
Oh, okay.
Oh, Missing. Oh, yeah. Okay. Nice. Again, I was really scratching here at the bottom of the barrel. So number five.
Okay,
is
wait. Baby. Just a second. Before you say, I know, but before you say this, when I was talking to Thomas like a couple days ago.
Don't.
No, you. Everybody has to hear this, even though you didn't work on those movies. Yeah. I know. But so Thomas, a couple days ago, before I had to give him a list of films with women in them.
I realized I hadn't seen any, which is not my fault. I'd say
Jenna Ortega. and Melissa Barrera in for Scream 6.
Let's blame the film industry as a whole for not showing me these films. No,
there are plenty. We all have.
And I sort them out afterwards. Like I actively went to watch them. So
I had.
You had to tell me which ones were good and which ones I would like. But anyway, I've made a more comprehensive list. Halle Bailey is still number 5 over The Little Mermaid, which probably does need fixing. And then number 4, Vivian Abara. Again, great co-lead, just great in that film. Julie Louise Dreyfus for You Hurt My Feelings, not No Hard Feelings. Sydney Sweeney for Reality, I thought she was excellent in that. For my winner, Rosie McEwen for Blue Jean. I thought she was easily the standout element of that film. I think it did help that the film around her was maybe slightly weaker to really amplify just how strong her performance was. And she's just doing a lot with this character. Like, it's a really impressive performance that I genuinely think might even end up in my top 5 by the end of the year.
She's stunning in that. Like, I was surprised by, like, when I got the screen, just, like, how good she actually is. Because, like, I'd heard some of the hype around and, like, some of the nominations she was getting, but, like, god damn, is she brilliant. Yeah. So... She's my number 6. She just missed out for me, but she was really, really close. But my number 5 is Margaret Qualley for Sanctuary. I can't wait. You guys got to see this performance as soon as possible. She is ridiculous. She is maniacal in this film. I mean, just crazy. And she owns the role. Then I got Sydney Sweeney for Reality. She's great. Michelle Williams showing up. I mean, Kelly Reichardt and Michelle Williams, just like a god tier, I mean, director actor duo, like incredible. Then I have Vivian Abara for Elaine, and my number 1 is Greta Lee for Past Lives. Performance of the year. I would be shocked if she isn't my number 1 by the end of the year, in all honesty. Brilliant stuff. So, okay, Greta Lee is in since he's number 1 for both Sam and I. Vivian Abara, I think we all have in.
Yeah.
Yeah, so this is again like just screenplay. This is again like the screenplay category where two people have Past Lives winning. Everyone's got Rylane in. Which one do we do? The win.
Yeah, so Sydney Sweeney, 3 of us have in.
I'd have her in 2. I forgot about that.
Two. Yeah. So Sydney Sweeney's in. And then both Sam and I have Michelle Williams. Both Jack and Sam and have Jennifer Lawrence.
And both Sam and I have Julie Louise Dreyfus. So
yeah. So
I guess Sam is the casting vote on that one, since he shared it with all of us. So whichever he did highest.
Yeah.
So he ranked them Jennifer Lawrence, Michelle Williams, Julia Louis-Dreyfus.
Okay, so the top.
So that would be...
How many places are there?
2. So it'd be Dreyfus missing out, and then Williams and Lawrence in.
Yeah, I think that works. Makes sense.
Yeah.
Does that work as their 5?
Yeah.
I think so.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Because because he put Jennifer Lawrence number 2. So I feel like that's fair.
Yeah.
And nobody else had Tiana Taylor. So I think that works.
Yeah.
Do we want to put Rosie McEwen in since she's your number 1?
No, I think crossovers are more than just a singular person having it in the list, even if it's number 1. This is a group list, so I'm fine leaving it off.
Hold up. I'm going to cut this out. We're going to do some maths. Okay. So we've done some math. So the top performers, I've done some math. So the order went Vivian Abara, Greta Lee, Sydney Sweeney, and then a 4-way. Michelle Williams was 4th. So it went Vivian Abara, Greta Lee, Sydney Sweeney, Michelle Williams, and then a 4-way tie for the final spot between Jennifer Lawrence, Julie Louis-Dreyfus, Tiana Taylor, and Rosie McEwen.
Okay.
Here's what I say.
Oh, this is complicated.
Yeah.
Here's what I would suggest.
Okay.
Let's just nominate all of them.
Why not?
It's our show.
Yeah.
Yes. There is a mathematical 4-way tie between them. I think it's fair if we just say do them all. We're the critic's choice of it. Just go around.
Yeah.
Do them all.
And there's been so many great actresses. I mean, and we're still leaving off people like Margaret Qualley. I mean, like Daisy Ridley, like Halle Bailey. Like,
yeah.
I'm fine with just throwing a bunch of people into this list.
Yes.
So, okay. The nominees for Best Actress are, after much deliberation, Vivian Abara for Rylane, Greta Lee for Past Lives, Sydney Sweeney for Reality, Michelle Williams for Showing Up, Jennifer Lawrence for No Hard Feelings, Julia Louis-Dreyfus for You Hurt My Feelings, Tiana Taylor for 1001, and Rosie McEwen for Blue Jean. And mathematically, it was Vivian Abara winning with Greta Lee 2nd, which I'm fine with.
Yeah.
Because we all had Abara high. So I think that works, and then we'll give Greta Lee runner-up, even though I think that if you guys have seen Past Lives, if you guys see it, probably be
everyone. Yeah, probably.
Yeah, but for some of us, that's not a mid-season film. That is a September release for some reasons.
It's just not playing near me.
Yeah.
And you're just too lazy to go.
I could drive like an hour and a half to go see an hour and a half film, but I won't.
I drove 2.5 hours to see it.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Just not dedicated.
I know. all right. Best director. Sam sent nothing for this. So.
Okay. No director's award this year is what you're saying.
Such a producer. All right. Yeah. Here we go. I'll start. Number 5, Lynn Tron, Waiting for the Light to Change. I also interviewed her on this channel, and she's really nice, and she made a really good movie, and you should watch it. Number 4, Raven Jackson for All Dirt Roads, Taste of Salt. I love when women direct indie movies. Number 3, I got Ari Aster for Beau Is Afraid. Number 2, I have Wes Anderson for Asteroid City. And number 1, I got Celine Song for Past Lives.
Okay, nice. I went for Rain Alan Miller for Rye Lane. This was their first directorial debut, wasn't it?
Yeah,
very impressive. Incredibly impressive. Yeah. Then Gabriel Martin for Mars 1. We'll get there. But yes, very well directed film. Wes Anderson for Asteroid City. I think it's very hard, if you enjoy that film, to not sort of honor at least the director. I didn't go for in screenplay, but I thought directing, you know what, Wes Anderson, you've done it. You've done an all right job there, I guess. then we've got Joaquin Dos Santos, Justin K. Thompson, and Ken Powers for Spider-Verse. And then Sam Sadiq for Joyland. So I went for Mars 1 winning screenplay, Joyland winning director. I just thought, you know, I'd share them out. I thought Joyland was probably a slightly stronger directorial vision maybe than it was screenplay, but it's equally worthy in both.
Brilliant, both. Yeah. All right, Jack, where are you at?
Okay. I've got Rain Alan Miller for Rye Lane. I've got the Spider-Verse team. I have Ari Aster for Beau Is Afraid. Then I did Chad Stahelski for John Wick 4. I wasn't a huge fan of it, but I do think direction-wise it was pretty impressive.
Yeah, that is.
And I'll throw, what's her name? Even though I wasn't a huge fan of the film, I thought it was very well directed, and I'll throw a bone your way, Trevor, for Raven Jackson for All Dirt Roads, Taste of Salt.
Let's go. Okay, so here's how we're sitting. So Rain Alan Miller's in, because she's shared between the two of you guys. The Spider-Verse team is shared between you guys.
Yeah, Wes Anderson is shared between us.
Yeah. And then Raven Jackson is shared. And then there's Celine Song and same Sadiq. I'm fine with just nominating them both and putting 6 in director.
Oh, sure. Yeah.
They're both our number one.
No, surely that's now 7. I swear.
Rain Alan Miller, the Spider-Verse crew, Ari Aster, Raven Jackson, Celine Song, same Sadiq. Oh, and then West.
Yeah.
7's
fine. Unless you just don't want to do Celine Song and Sam Sadiq, which is probably.
I feel like you should.
Sure.
Celine Song should probably be in there.
Probably. Okay, we
never
can do
7. Never going to do same Sadiq. Who cares?
Yeah, exactly.
Still less than Critics' Choice.
Yeah. God, they did do 10, didn't they? They really 10. Did do 10. I always forget they did that.
Yeah. Okay, cool. So then as far as a winner, I mean, I feel like it's the Spider-Verse team is the highest. Who would be your winner, Jack?
Probably Rain Alan Miller.
Okay.
For Rye Lane.
Yeah, and then, that is my number 5.
Your second then?
Probably the Spider-Verse team then.
That's so probably second, the Spider-Verse team is the winner.
Yeah.
Probably would end up, yeah.
And then I think, how would you rank the rest of yours? Ari, Chad, Raven? How would go?
That's how it'd go.
So I think that puts Ari Aster, Rain Alan Miller.
Where do you have Wes Anderson, Trevor?
Oh, I have Wes second.
I've got him 3rd, so I feel like that would make him.
So I feel like that makes Wes Anderson runner-up, yeah.
Yeah.
All right, so the winner is the Spider-Verse crew, runner-up, Wes Anderson.
Indeed.
All right, time to get into Best Picture, and it's time to bust out the math again.
Yeah, this one's going to be a bit complex, so...
Okay, and Sam has sent a full list for this one, so we can go fully if we have 10, we can math this one out. I'll start. Why not? I'll start us off. Number 10, Rye Lane. Number 9, Joyland. Number 8, Showing Up. Number 7, Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse. Number 6, Gennemarink. Number 5, All Dirt Roads, Taste of Salt. Number 4, Asteroid City. That's a lie. Number 4 is Waiting for the Light to Change. Number 3 is Beau Is Afraid. Number two is Astrid City. Number one is Rylane.
Nope, that's
or Past Lives.
Number one is Past Life.
I know your number one is yeah.
It's your number one and your number 10.
Yeah. You watched it twice.
Just back it.
Let's go to Jack now.
Okay, I'm not gonna do 10 here because then I'd be throwing in stuff like John Wick, and that's not gonna get it anyways. So I've got Rylane, Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse, Bo is Afraid, Blackberry, Sometimes I Think About Dying. I did like Guardians of the Galaxy 3. I know you guys weren't huge on it, but I did like
it. Hey, no, it's coming.
Oh, okay.
I wasn't huge on it.
Okay, I see.
Right. Yeah.
And then 1001.
Okay, nice. I mean, yeah, I will preface this by saying my 9 and 10 are two films that I think are pretty good, but not great. So they are Blackberry and Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3, just sneaking in. Number 8, Blue Jean, great film. I mean, Rosie McGowan, I think, is definitely carrying that film to some extent, but he's carrying it well. 7, Astro Tissy, like this one more than I expected. You can check out the review on the channel now, so I'll plug there. Number 6, Are You There, God? It's Me, Margaret. Just a delightful film. Number 5, You Hurt My Feelings. Just a delightful film. Number 4, Rylane. Just a delightful film. I feel like they're the trender. Then number 3, Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse. How could it not at least be in your top 10? And then my number 2 and 1 are probably to be expected if you've been following the nomination I've been doing. So number 2, Joyland. Just missing out on number 1, which is Mars 1. Which, yeah, I think it was in my top 10 technically last year, but then also it's technically wasn't released until this year, so it's complicated, but it deserves honoring again. I don't think enough people have seen it, but you should.
Yeah, no, absolutely. All right, and then Sam's list goes number 10, Bo is Afraid, number 9, Polite Society, number 8, Rylane, number 7, No Hard Feelings, number 6, You Hurt My Feelings, number 5, Are You There, God? It's Me, Margaret, number 4, Showing Up, number 3, Joyland. Number 2, Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse. Number 1, Past Lives.
Lovely stuff.
I'd have already there, got it to be Margaret as well. I forgot about that. So that'd be
okay.
On my
mind. Okay. All right. So time to math this. The mathing has been completed. Are you ready for our nominees?
Yes.
Here we go. In alphabetical order.
Ooh, like the Oscars.
Yeah. Are You There, God? It's Me, Margaret. Asteroid City. Bo is Afraid. Joyland. Good. Mars 1. Past Lives. Rylane. Showing Up. Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse. And You Hurt My Feelings.
Okay.
That's a good list.
I'm very happy with that list. Yeah.
Things that just missed out were things like Blackberry, Waiting for the Light to Change, Alder, Six Assault. But it was basically just it was everything that had crossover, and then Mars 1, since that was your
name. Oh, well. Yes. There we go.
So,
all my top 7 and above managed to get in. So I'm very happy with that.
So our winner was Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse.
Okay.
With our runner-up being Rylane. Third place was Past Lives. Fourth
still very
was Joyland.
Good. I haven't seen it. So
and fifth is Bo's Afraid. Yeah, and like, let's be honest. If you guys had seen it, winner would probably be Past Lives. That's going it off only be. Two of us having seen it. But Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse is our winner. So just to recap, Spider-Verse wins Picture and Director, just like the ACAs.
Yeah, exactly. I'm just copying the ACAs.
Vivian Aparra takes Actress. Joaquin Phoenix takes actor, John McGraw takes supporting actor, Alina Khan takes supporting actors, and Past Live takes screenplay.
Also copying the HGA.
But... Hey, listen, you know.
Pretty similar.
I think that overall we did pretty good. I think that this is a pretty fun list overall. And you'll see the four of us. Hopefully Sam will be able to be here next time. We'll do this again at the end of the year. I think it would be fun.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll have seen a lot more better stuff, hopefully.
Yeah. All the awesome stuff.
Yeah, you don't.
Yeah. Yeah,
but I think we've done quite well, and oh no, maybe we could do this for TV as well if we've seen enough.
Maybe
I've seen a lot of TV.
Yeah, I'm getting there.
I've seen bare minimum required to sort of get by. Like I've seen Succession, I've seen Ted Lasso, you know.
Okay.
Yeah. But anyways, that is it. Thank you everybody so much for watching. Let us know what you thought of our picks. What you think we got right, what you think we got wrong, and let us know your picks for your favorites in each category so far this year in the comments below. And if you think that there's some that we're missing that maybe we haven't seen, I'm always up for a recommendation. As made evident, I watch a lot of new releases. So I'll watch anything. So just throw it at me. But that is it. So thank you everybody so much for watching. You can find all of our social media stuff in the description, as well as Jack's channel and Twitter, Letterboxd, all those types of stuff where you can find Jack, because you know, if you'll probably like his stuff if you like us.
Maybe.
But that is it. So thank you everybody so much for watching. And until next time, stay safe and goodbye.